Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning. Praise for them springing fresh from the world. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness when his feet pass. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new. Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for the springing fresh from.
From He Chose Nails. Have you ever wondered why God gives so much? We could exist on far less, wouldn't you think? He could have left the world flat and gray. We wouldn't have known the difference, but He didn't. He splashed orange in the sunrise and cast the sky in blue. And if you love to see geese as they gather, chances are you'll see that too. Did He have to make the squirrels' tails furry? Was He obliged to make the birds sing? And the funny way that chickens scurry, or majesty of thunder when it rings? Why give a flower fragrance? Why give food its taste? Could it be He loves to see that look upon your face?
We thank Candy for the reading and Max Licato for the poem. And Leela has a song for us. He is alive.
This is very hot. Isn't God good?
Yes, all the time.
All the time.
Yes, all the time.
God is time, good is God.
He's an amazing Father. The gates and doors were barred and all the windows fastened down. I spent the night in sleeplessness and rose at every sound. With sorrow, half in fear, the day returned. Soldiers breaking through to drag us all the way. Not my microphone, the music, son. It was just before the sunrise, I heard something at the wall. The gate began to rattle, a voice began to call. I ran to the window, looked down into the street, expecting swords and torches, the sound of soldiers' feet. There was no one there but Mary, so I ran to let her in. John stood there beside me as he told us where she'd been. She said they took him in the night and none of us knows where. The stone's been rolled away and now his body isn't there. We both ran toward the garden, John ran on ahead. We found the stone, an empty tomb, just the way that Mary said. The winding clothes they'd wrapped him in were just an empty shell. And how or where they'd taken him was more than I could tell. Something strange had happened there, just what I did not know. John believed a miracle, but I just turned to go. Circumstance and speculation couldn't lift me very high. I'd seen them crucify my Lord, I'd watched him die. Back inside the house again, the guilt and anguish came. Everything I'd promised him just added to my shame. When at last it came to choices, I denied I knew his name. And even if he was alive, how could it be the same? Jesus. Suddenly the air was filled with a strange and sweet perfume. Light that came from everywhere drove shadows from the room. And Jesus stood before me with his arms held open wide. I fell down to my knees. I clung to him and cried. As he raised me to my feet, and as I looked into his eyes, the love was shining out from him like sunlight from the skies. Guilt in my confusion disappeared in sweet release, and every fear I'd ever had just melted into peace.
Robert is going to share from us from the Message Bible, Mark 16, 1 through 7.
when the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, the solemn brought spices so they could embalm them. Very early on Sunday morning, as the sun rose, they went to the tomb. They worried out loud to each other, "Who will roll back the stone from the tomb for us?" Then they looked up, saw that it had been rolled back. It was a huge stone, and walked right in. They saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed all in white. They were completely taken back, astonished. He said, "Don't be afraid. I know you're looking for Jesus the Nazarene, the one they nailed on the cross. He's been raised up. He's here no longer. You can see for yourselves that the place is empty. Now on your way. Tell his disciples and Peter that he is going on ahead of you to Galilee. You'll see him there, exactly as he said."
It is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Sunrise is an emotional time for those of us who are believers. And so if we could put into words, the rest of the world may understand even more. But the truth is that it's hard sometimes to be descriptive of things we don't understand. Probably since we are experiencing our new and first grandchild, K3, we have this sensation that we want to share love in a very new and different way. Have you ever looked at someone with that special love that you cherish that person and feel different than ever before? The English language doesn't cover that. But there is a word that makes me think of what Candy says quite often. It's this irresistible urge to pinch or to squeeze someone. That's the feeling you get from a new grandchild, and many of you have experienced that, or your own children. There is a word, however, giggle, spelt G-I-G-L-E in the Philippines, which describes that essence to a T. But in English, there's nothing that quite captures the emotion that you feel. There are many emotions that are not part of our English language. Perhaps the emotion we feel this morning on sunrise service. The heavy fog, the dew, the excitement, the sun that's rising behind me. The sun that's rising behind me.
By faith.
These are experiences that we would like to put into words that sometimes our language just doesn't cover. How about the song that we sing by tradition, Cat Stevens' Morning is Broken, and the lyrics that go like, "Blackbird has spoken like the first bird, praise for his singing. Every morning when I come, there's a mockingbird that stays right in this tree and greets me, singing." If there were words that I could express the joy that that bird shares with me each morning. Some of you may like walking in the wind. How do you describe that? Some of you may even like to turn and walk into the wind. What a different emotion that would be. There's a Dutch word, at weien. Wait till you hear how you spell this. U-I-T-A-A-I-E-N. It's Dutch. And it describes that sensation that we have of the breeze blowing either into our face or from behind us, propelling us forward. If we could understand the English language even more, we could probably live life a lot richer and more successful because of this enhanced awareness that we feel with the world around us. In our stream of consciousness, we are bathed in different sensations, different feelings, different emotions. There's so much for us to process just in living. And in that, many things just pass by us because we have no way to understand, no way to describe exactly how we are feeling. Because you see, with our language barriers, we have a way of labeling things. And when we cannot label them, that emotion, that feeling seems to pass us by. We can't articulate the things to other people that we'd like to share from the joy we receive out of God's wonderful world. Maybe if our language were expanded to include these shivering exposures, we could articulate the whole new areas of experience that currently are very faintly noticed. Easter is a unique moment, a unique experience that involves unique emotions that come from within. It's the kind that kind of gets in the back of your throat and keeps you from saying to other people, here's how I feel with the presence of God surrounding me. Now think of those who came to the tomb, Mary and Peter and John, hampered by the language barriers of their time as they poke their head in, go into a tomb where Jesus is gone. We read in the scripture that everything was folded and placed just so. I knew that Jesus had OCD. But his body was gone. And the horror that came upon Mary in those first moments from that initial encounter were quickly replaced with joy of realization that Jesus is alive, truly alive. Since we are splitting linguistical hairs, let our emotional journey today be enhanced as we desperately desire to understand this joyous feeling that we have of Easter Sunday morning. Sunrise is not described as an emotion. Sunrise experience of Easter is a condition of deep gladness, delight, the exaltation of our spirit. It is a sense that we may have encountered as we dove into the spiritual essence of the Last Supper this past week. It's an expansion of those feelings that are so different than things that we commonly talk about. This joy that we feel inside gets transferred from Jesus to us. It's an appreciation of God's promise fulfilled and completed. Our eternity and the salvation of the world counted upon this very day, this very moment, so many years ago, and I would shout to you, hallelujah. Easter joy supersedes any emotion of our current lives. No depression, no pain that cannot be encountered now with the foreknowledge that God is God, God is good, and God is love. It has never been more effectively proclaimed than by the lyrics of that old Negro spiritual that I grew up with. Sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down, but my soul is still heaven bound. Swing low, sweet chariot. That's encountered joy that words just cannot grasp. That's the kind of feeling that impels us to be proudly known as Easter people. Beyond that, it's truly difficult to explain what it means to belong to Jesus. He is ours, we are his, and I thank God for that. You feel the breeze?
Yes.
From the front and from the back? So when we say in the morning of this day, he is risen.
He is risen indeed.
I think you've got the message. And all the children say,
Amen. Amen.
all bad stuff.
Well, I know that God answers every prayer. I've been told, be careful of what you pray for. I prayed there would be no rain this morning.
It's like a happy medium.
It's not raining. I pray each week. Turn me down, just way down. Is that better? I pray each week that the experience, I tell you what, as much as I
hate to do this, try this one.
I was going
to
say, just to make that sure that one's off, you shouldn't have them.
It was off, but anyway, I pray that that every time you come into God's house, that the experience that you share will do something to your enthusiasm and your understanding of love. I pray that when you are present in God's world, that you find something that gives you that feeling of the wind in your face, the wind in your back, the wind that blows your notes off the
podium.
Pulpit. Believe it or not, this is a pulpit for us. Take this fancy shroud off and it's a music stand. You see, that's the joy of knowing Jesus. Even if we have to arise on our one day to be here early, God is present with us.
Amen.
And we feel that so close on events and seasons like this. So with that, let us go into prayer to thank God for the joy of this morning. Pray with me. Lord, we thank you for your presence in our lives. We thank you for your presence in our world, and give us the courage, we ask, to go from here excited, empowered to make a difference in the world around us from the joy that we experience in the life that you lived for us, to change our world, to change our lives. We thank you for those who are faithful to come out and celebrate your risen life for us. You've given everything. Let us expand that into our community and our world. We thank you, Lord, for this blessing of a wonderful day. We ask you to continue to stay with us and to bless our faith community as we grow and are empowered to share the gospel. And the children say,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I have to tell you a story real quick. We chose this last song.
Love you, Frank.
From an experience of great joy. There was a music teacher in the children's home in Dunellen.
Near Daytona.
Deltona. Thank you. One of the things that he taught the young people, not only with instruments, but vocally, he used this song, which Candy has now insisted that we play when she is no longer with us. But we're going to play it while she is with us. And it seems so appropriate because it is a time of joy. Oh, happy day. Will you stand and join with me?
I like that one too.
He is risen indeed.
Join us for breakfast.
Yes.
And all the children say,
Amen.
We'd like to carry our